because she doesn't see the urgency of mama.
Is he asking God, please may they be there? And where did you get the money? You are ungrateful. I'm never buying you anything. Never again. Never.
Four of us, remember, it's 8 o'clock at night, it's dark. We're walking now, people are jumping over the gate, people are screaming, people are getting into their cars.
Where was I going? Not panicking, breathing in, breathing out, looking again
because you are going to find them to come out. But I wasn't gonna come out like that. I had to obviously, you know, say my toothbrush, you know. So now I message my mom, she's at church, remember. So I message her and I tell her that we need to go to my friend's house because I left my toothbrush, I left my face wash, I left my this, I left my that. My mom's like,
you can just get it tomorrow.
I'm like, ma'am, I need to get my toothbrush and my thingies right now. She's like,
you can just wait, like, just ask your friend to bring it for you. And
then I'm just like, okay, fine, I left my AirPods at this place that we slept at, we booked at a place, I did this and this and that. I literally tell her the truth because she doesn't see the urgency of me getting to these places, to this place right now. She's like, you what?
We'll talk at home.
At this point, I'm just like,
what have I done to myself?
What have I done to myself? And then, okay, now I'm carrying on with this hello. And now I'm obviously trying to think of other things to say because I can't just say one thing, you know. Everything needs to make sense. So I'm busy thinking, okay, I'm doing my hello at the same time. I'm
busy asking God, that, God, please may they be there, like, yo.
Otherwise, I'm going to hell, basically.
In essence, I was basically going to hell. And even though I was already in hell,
now I hear the car in the driveway.
My heart.
Oh. Heart? My heart is beating faster than it's ever beaten before.
I hear the mean door cuckoo.
Yo, at this point, I have to act like I can't hear her because I'm scared. So now the main door is like here. I don't know if you guys will see, but the main door is here and I'm in study. So it's like passage, left, and then corner right, so like we're this much apart but obviously bigger, and I can hear her. So now I hear her walking.
All the other days I never hear her footsteps, but today I am hearing the
of the heels. She comes to study, she's like, yeah, Utin. I'm like, no,
I think I lost my AirPods
at the place that we were sleeping at. She's like,
were you not at your friend's house?
No, I was at my friend's house, but then we went to we booked at a guest house. We booked at a lodge together because we wanted to spend time together for my birthday.
You what?
Yeah, we booked at a place.
And where did you get the money?
Yay, guys, that was a long 10 minutes of my life. She's like,
so what do you want us to do?
I'm like, no, we need to go fish the thing in right now and all of that stuff. And my friends are picking up her phone, so I have to go there for myself.
She's like,
Iwandis, if we go there and I work on my AirPods, I need to go to the luto. You are ungrateful. I'm never buying you anything. Never again. Never.
At this point, I'm just like, yo, I was scared for my life. So obviously, if this place was close to my house, I would have done means. I would have called everybody to take me there. But this place is far. It's literally like 30 minutes or 20 minutes away from my house. So I can't go there on my own. I couldn't go on my own. So I had to come out. Anyway, she's like, Asambe, get into the car. I'm trying to text my friends like, yo guys, this is what's happening, whatever. Telling my best friend that you're doing this, was happening. My best friend's not even picking up at this point, like he was basically useless. Okay, get into the car now. The car is going so slow, the radio is off. All I'm hearing is the wheels of the car. I'm hearing the indicator going. That was the longest 20 minutes or 30 minutes of my life. So obviously I told my mom that this place is closer to my friend's house, because I couldn't just say like it's further, because you know it needs to make sense, right? So now we get to like the area, and I'm just telling her turn left, turn right, turn this. We eventually get the mom's like,
didn't she say it's close to your friend's house?
I keep quiet. Gets to the place, the lady, luckily she recognized me, gets to the place. Good then, I'm like, oh no, hi, yeah, I was here yesterday, whatever. And we left stuff, I left my AirPods, my earphones, blah, 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 blah. She's like, oh, okay, she gives me a plastic. I'm making sure that I open every single thing that is inside before I get to the car, because if I do not find these things right now, if I don't find my AirPods right now, I'm basically done. Like, I shouldn't even go back to the car, basically. So now I look through the plastic. I'm looking, like, we left a lot of things. I literally left my face cloth, and I left my face wash. My friends also left their face stuff. I'm out. Ding, 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 ding.
AirPods, 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 ha, ha.
I'm not getting a beating. I'm not getting a beating. I'm not getting a beating.
I'm not ungrateful. I'm not ungrateful. So obviously I'm happy, because I'm like, yo, I almost lost this thing worth 2k. I only got it on Wednesday. Today is Sunday. How is that even making sense? Get back into the car. She's like, did you buy it? And I'm like, yes. At this point, I'm like, yes. But obviously straight face, like, yes. Get into the car, go back home. And then she keeps quiet, really. Get home. I took a nap because I'm tired from the weekend. I'm tired, guys. And then it's like 6 now. So I go back to do my aloe, go back to do my useless work that is due on the Monday. I go and I do it and I do it. Now, obviously, I'm in the study. My parents are like in the lounge, which is close to the study. Okay, I'm thinking everything's good. Like, I got my AirPods. I'm the girl I think I am. I still had a good weekend. I was still independent with the girlies. We still had the time of our life. Then I hear my phone ring and look down. My mom calls me. She doesn't scream out my name. She phone calls me. And I pick up and I'm like, hello. Because I'm thinking, you know, we're besties now. Like, oh, hello. She's like,
Biela.
Oh, whatever. Get to the lounge, whatever. My dad's there now. So now it's the three of us. She's like, sit down. Yeah, guys, sit down. Obviously, she's like,
tell your father where you were.
And I'm like,
how? I told you.
I'm telling my mom that I told her. She's like,
Tell your father where you were.
I'm just like,
I was at a friend's house. I was with my friends. We booked at a place and we paid or whatever. We're all together. And yeah, I didn't tell you guys because I knew that you guys wouldn't let me go.
My dad's like,
Wendy's.
I'm obviously shying away. I'm not trying to give eye contact, because then, okay, my dad's like,
Wendy's, where did you get the money?
I'm like, no, I saved. I did this and that. He's like, My mom is like,
now you think you're old. You think you can go out with your friends and do anything you wanted to do. Look at what happened now. What happened because you didn't tell us the truth. If you told us the truth, you wouldn't be in the situation right now. You don't listen. You don't do this. You didn't do this.
I'm just like, And obviously, they were like, I must never do it again. I must be a good child. I'm in my trick now. I need to be serious about life. I need to be serious about school. I must tell the truth. Da, 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 da. And obviously, I had to apologize because that's the right thing to do, you know? And then after apologizing and after the whole lecture that happened, I didn't get a beating. Basically, all that happened. So basically, my weekend went from good to a bad ending. And that all happened because I didn't tell my parents the truth. I thought I was the girl I thought I was, but I was definitely not the girl I thought I was. So basically, the moral of the story is that tell your parents where you are going and what your plans are. Because if something happens and things don't turn out the way that it's supposed to turn, you're gonna be 6 feet under in a second. Okay, especially if you have strict parents like me. Well, anyways, I hope you guys learned a thing or two about me and my mischievous ways. and that you guys enjoyed the story time. And if you guys enjoyed it, if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And also, if you don't mind, share your stories, man. Like, I'd like to know if you were ever in trouble. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Mwah.